What's up, everybody? It's Meech. You're tuned into On The Radar. Currently on the radar is zinc. Zinc is just one of the 92 minerals found in our sea moss products, along with magnesium, iron, calcium, iodine, potassium. That's just to name a few. We ain't going to list them all. But I'm doing a series of videos breaking down these different vitamins and minerals and what they do for us. So you can catch it up here. You can also find the link in the description. I might even leave it in the first comment. It's the first comment in the comment section. So it's important to know what these vitamins and minerals are doing for us. We're all taking sea moss. We're getting the benefits. But I want you guys to start knowing which vitamins and minerals are responsible for what. And a lot of times we're getting the benefits, but we still may not be getting enough. So we need to know what's what, what's happening, if we got to add, subtract. We need to know these things. So definitely, you know, watch the videos. All right, let's get started because I got a lot of good information for you. Zinc is a mineral found. I messed up already. Let's rewind. Let's act like that didn't happen. Let's start over. Zinc is a mineral that is present in many of the body's functions. It is the second most abundant mineral in the body next to iron. It plays a role in immune function, thyroid function, protein synthesis, wound healing, DNA synthesis, and cell division. Zinc also supports normal growth and development during pregnancy, childhood, and adolescence, and is required for a proper sense of taste and smell. A daily zinc intake is needed to maintain a steady state because the body has no specialized zinc storage. We don't store zinc. The anti-inflammatory properties of zinc helps the body to reduce swelling and redness in people with acne. In addition, studies show that patients who use zinc notice a decrease in active breakout compared to those who didn't use zinc. And since zinc helps with wound healing, it can help to reduce any residual acne scarring. Zinc helps to reduce triglyceride levels and bad cholesterol, so this will help against heart disease. It also helps against it helps with controlling blood sugar levels, and that helps with diabetes. It also helps to maintain testosterone, vitality, libido, and muscle mass. A lot of you guys who are like, yo, since I started taking the sea moss, I've been different, you know, in the bed, and I've been ready to go, and, you know. And that's what everybody, especially if you know people from the Caribbean, they've been saying that forever. Zinc is one of those reasons why. Just so you know, zinc activates T cells. Those T cells attack infected and cancerous cells. That regulates your immune response. Zinc also impacts the healing of wounds by helping with the production of collagen. Collagen boosts tissue growth in and around the cut area and allowing it to heal. So it helps with blood clotting. Zinc is also excellent for helping with the common cold, and it helps to reduce the inflammation in and around the mouth where most of the cold virus is present. Our body does not produce zinc. Just like I said, it doesn't store it, doesn't produce it. So we got to consume it from outside sources. Some of those natural sources include oysters, red meat, lobster, salmon, chicken, beans, nuts, dairy products, whole grains, spinach, asparagus, pumpkin seeds. So, of course, you can also get it from sea moss. A 20-gram serving of raw iris sea moss contains, which is about 4 tablespoons, provides 4% of your daily recommended value of zinc. It also gives you 10% of iron, 7% magnesium, while only providing 10 calories. So it's high nutrients, low calories. Of course, you don't want to just get your anything from one source. So make sure you do a mix of natural foods, get some sea moss, take your vitamins if you need to take, whatever, but just make sure you get enough zinc, you get all the other things you need. Don't just rely on one thing, okay? Don't even just take the sea moss, and then when you're saying, oh, I'm feeling better, I'm getting the benefits, you still should consult with your doctor, maybe get your levels checked, because even though you might be feeling better, you probably still need more, and you could be feeling even better. Just think about that. So always consult with your doctor, get your levels checked. Know what you need and what you don't need, okay? Now, let's move forward. Signs of zinc deficiency include loss of appetite, stomach growth, poor immune function, and in severe deficiency cases, people can experience loss of hair, loss of weight, diarrhea, impotence, eye and skin lesions, mental fog, abnormal sense of taste, slow wound healing. So you'll know if you're not getting enough zinc. And if you're experiencing any of those things, get you some damn zinc. Get you some damn sea moss. You can find also a lot of over-the-counter options for zinc, like pills, lozenges, ointments, sprays, all that type of stuff. So there's so many different ways to get it. Increase your damn zinc intake, people. I can't stress that enough. You remember when the whole pandemic thing started and a lot of people was like, zinc, 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 because zinc helps boost your immune system. Now, I'm not going to get into a whole rant of why that wasn't stressed even more and it's not still being stressed, but anybody that's been taking CMOS knows for the past, you know, if you've been taking it during this time, you know it's been keeping your immune system strong. And one of those key things, obviously, is zinc. Increase your zinc, people. Anyway, let's move forward. I'm not here to go on rants. Side effects of consuming zinc in large amounts include diarrhea, vomiting, abdominal cramps. And if you do experience these things, when you stop taking it or you decrease it, they will go away shortly. So, you know, don't panic, but just make sure, you know, you slow down, it'll go away. Antibiotics should be taken an hour before consuming zinc or 4 to 6 hours after consuming zinc. Diuretics can reduce zinc absorption by as much as 60%. Definitely consult with your doctor before using zinc. This is another thing to think about. You want to get your zinc in the most bio available ways, you know, the natural ways, because your body will break it down and absorb it properly. Sometimes people who are taking different multivitamins and stuff like that, their body doesn't always absorb it and break it down. So you're taking it, but you're not feeling the benefits and you don't know why. It's because your body's not absorbing it. And obviously, like I just said, depending on what you're putting in your body, it may be reducing the chances of your body absorbing it. So definitely know the ins and the outs of this stuff. Be aware of what's putting in your body at all times. Be aware of what you're putting in your body, and also be aware of what might be counteracting. The same way you worry about when you're taking medications, if there's going to be counter interactions and stuff like that, think about when you're taking anything natural, make sure you're not taking something that's not allowing your body to absorb it. Because that's why a lot of times people will use something for a short period of time and they say, oh, I don't feel anything. I don't notice anything. One, sometimes you have to give your body a little bit more time, but then also you have to make sure that your body's absorbing it. So before you just discontinue something or you just knock it and say, oh, it's not working, check all those other boxes off. Make sure you're not doing something to hinder, you know, your body to process that stuff properly. So, I just totally lost my whole train of thought, but that was important. But definitely now, you know, you might want to consider adding some zinc to your daily regimen. And with it being so many different forms of available, there's no real reason not to, you know, try it out, incorporate it. Definitely go to RadarPlusNutrition.com right now. Order some CMOS. The link is in the description. If you found any of this information helpful, please subscribe, hit the like button, follow us on Instagram, link in the description, Radar Plus Nutrition, it's not hard to find us. Check out some of our other content also all throughout the YouTube channel. We got tons of good content. Also, like I said, check out the playlist that I'm doing about these different vitamins and minerals in the CMOS. Another thing, seriously, make sure you share these videos and this content and this information with your friends and family. If you care about them, if you love them, care about their well-being. Don't wait till they're sick. Don't wait till they tell you that there's something wrong to then say, oh, check this out. Try this. Take that. Let's make it cool to start sharing health, sharing wealth, sharing well-being. Let's make it cool. Let's not wait till something goes wrong. We celebrate things, you know, sometimes that we shouldn't be celebrating. Like, you know, it's no problem to drink, have shots on good occasions and, you know, let's go drink, let's go eat, let's celebrate. Let's make it cool to share healthy stuff. We live longer, we feel better, we look better. Let's make that cool. Anyway, no more rants. But just share, people. Share, share, share. You don't want to be the only one healthy around. So again, once again, I'm Meech. I appreciate you guys for tuning in to On The Radar. Until next time, stay focused, stay fit. Salute. Stay healthy.